welcome. Welcome to your mom's house with Tom Segura. Tom Segura.
And Christina Pajitsin.
Welcome to your mom's house.
And God bless the nigga. I'm blessed right now. I'm talking about, you feel me? I mean,
God blesses a nigga. God blesses a nigga. Wow, amen. God is real. God blesses a nigga. All you niggas is blessed. Stabbed 12 times. Why the fuck are you still standing on that street that you just got stabbed on? Wouldn't you never go there again? Yeah, then don't fucking go there anymore if you're gonna get stabbed. Wow, amen. And if you get shot on a certain neighborhood, don't go to the neighborhood. What's wrong with y'all? What's wrong with y'all? This is a nigga. All you niggas is blessed.
God damn it.
Ali sent that in. It's called Pastor Pajitsky, Sermon 74.
Thanks, asshole. Woo! All of you are assholes. That was so old.
Yeah.
And what episode was that? Two?
I don't know how long ago that was. It was a while ago. It was definitely a while ago, but that
was
incredible.
Look at you in blue bands. So feeling thrilled good with yourselves, huh?
Oh, it looks like you're hydrating with some coffee.
No, looks like I'm hydrating with a full... I already drank half of it before the show. Where's your water bottle?
Oh, I have one.
Where is it? May I see? Where have you been hiding that? Interesting. Uh-huh.
I see caffeine in front of you, too.
Yeah, well, I hydrate and dehydrate at the same time because I know what I'm doing. This is so childish. Look at you. You're so childish. You drank like Ellis drinks out of a sippy cup. Oh, my God. Oh, that's it? That's all you got?
One sip. That's just
look
one.
I know that you think you do volume. Look, next to me I have this, one, a backup,
yeah,
and a third. That's empty because I drank it all.
You drank it like last week.
No, it's always here. Look.
Can we get into this, please?
Oof. Lipstick on the microphone. You guys are terrible, both of you. I hate you both the most. You sound like Tom Lincoln.
Yeah. Dump that bitch.
Really?
Really.
Okay. Check it out.
Worse.
Thank you, Wet Nut Sack. it was great. I had a blast with you guys. An absolute blast.
Did you blast a lot there?
I didn't blast
you
a
didn't?
Lot there. No, no.
That's surprising.
But it was really fun shows, and I thank all you Jews for coming out.
I'm sorry?
And what? There's a huge Hasidic Jewish population.
I know. They all stayed in my hotel last time I was there. Like, Hasidic. Is that what you are, Blue Man? You're Ashkenazi.
Next.
What are you?
I am Ashkenazi. Hasidic is just a type of... like.
I know. Hasidic. Hasidic, Ashkenazi, and...
No.
Sammy Davis. What kind is there?
No, Ashkenazi is... like, he can't... white.
I can't hear what he's saying.
I don't hear anything from you.
Oh, yeah, it works when you put your mitt on there.
Hey.
There we go.
Okay. Well, Ashkenazi is like a white Jew. Sephardi is a Spanish Jew. Hasidic is just religious. So.
Listen.
There you go.
It's too complicated.
Yeah.
You guys are so complicated.
I think the real problem is that there's too many of you. You know what I mean? So.
Guys, let's make America great again.
Anyways. Next week, I'm in Dribbly Brown Shit.
What is it, that one? Either?
Liberty Township.
That's really good.
That's by Christy submitted that.
Dribbledy.
dribbly brown shit. That's it's just outside of the greater Cincinnati area. That means I'm coming home, James.
Oh my god!
You know, I haven't been to my hometown in a while.
You mean are you going to take a pilgrimage to the hotel that it happened?
What do you think? Of course, and Blue Band's coming with me.
Are you going to stay in room 618?
You'll see.
Oh shit!
We're making the trip of our lives.
Well, should I clear my calendar and join you guys?
What?
With the baby and everything?
Make it a family event?
Well, I mean, it's kind of a big deal.
We'll just sit there and weep for a week? after that, I am going to... where am I going? Manly Blow... Hold on. Someone sent this one in.
God damn,
it's San Diego.
Fucker.
What is it? Manly Dago? No.
Oh, my God.
It's on the cheat sheet, I think.
Is it? Is it from the... From
Man... Mantaleblo? I don't know.
Somebody put it Man. Was really good. I don't know. Anyways, it's San Diego.
Well, it's Man Diego, we always call it.
Man
right?
Diego. Right? Yeah. But somebody put like Blow a Dago or something like
oh,
that.
Oh, Blow a Dago's good.
so I'm in Blow a Dago at the American Comedy Company. And very much looking forward to that. Those tickets are really going fast. I always do well in that area.
This is such bullshit, by the way.
Oh, you'll see.
You think I don't know that this guy didn't pick it up for you on the way in today?
Do you think that this is the only thing that you're going to get moated on? This episode? You don't think that you're going to get that
no.
This is the beginning?
Oh, no.
You think I was just going to sit back? Do you know who you're dealing with? Come on.
You're just upset because I won last episode with the water champion.
You don't even know what's going to happen.
I don't. I'm scared now.
You should be. You should be
Fuck.
Terrified.
Whatever.
Anyways,
I know you're ramping up for something big because you did the NIGG song at the
top.
Can
we get back to the dates?
Oh, I'm sorry.
July 14th through 16th is Blow a Dago, and then St. Jude Tits, Missouri, July 21st through 23rd. And then I have a bunch of dates added. I'm going to Charlotte, North Carolina.
Classic, standard, yeah.
I'm going to come all over, blow us, come blow us, Ohio.
Oh, I love come blow us.
Yeah.
It's fun.
Fartladelphia, Jew Dork Titties.
That's my favorite.
Yeah.
So Jew Dork Titties is really good.
Please go to TomSegura.com, the shows page. Hit the shows page. All the tickets are there. Jeans, I know you got some dates.
I do. I'm doing one-nighters. I'm back. I'm back in the rotation starting September 27th, Seattle, Washington at the To Come On You Comedy Club. So technically... Oh, stop it. You're showing off now. To Come On Your Comedy Club, September 28th, Portland, Oregon at Helium Comedy. Stop it. Helium Comedy Club, October 4th. What's Dallas?
Fallas,
Texas. Hyenas Comedy Club, October 5th. And Fuck My Holston. Yeah.
Okay.
Houston. At the Secret Group, October 23rd, I have added a date, Indianapolis, Indiana, Morty's Comedy Club. So get your tickets at thousandranch.com. That's thousand with the word spelled out, ranch.com. Come see me, guys. See me drink water on stage, because that's what I do. I hydrate 24/7.
Okay.
Yeah, are you done? Y'all done? Y'all finished?
I'm finished and I'm done. so much exciting, airy things to talk about this episode. But first, we got to take care of our business, Jeans.
Oh, yeah. May I say to everybody, if you use Amazon, I do hope you're using our banner. Go to yourmomshousepodcast.com, click on the banner at the bottom of the homepage, and do your shopping as you normally would. It just helps the show.
We even have an Amazon Canada banner as well.
We do. So, .ca.
.ca.
Okay.
For Canada.
CA, yo.
All right. Here we go, Jeans.
Oh, shit.
No, this is nothing to do with you, I promise.
Yeah, right.
I promise.
If you do not thrive, to be the best. If you do not push yourself to be the greatest,
yeah,
you will accomplish nothing.
Yeah.
How badly do you want it? How badly do you want it?
Okay.
This is big time.
Who is Randy?
Don't bring anyone mother to this.
Your mama in the fucking stand!
Welcome. Welcome to your mom's house. With Tom Segura. And
Christina Pajitza. Christina
Pajitza. Welcome to your mom's house.
I'm right. So
you shouldn't drink a gallon of fluid in an hour. I once dared an old boss to drink a gallon of milk in an hour.
That's different.
It's bad.
That's different.
But I think it's a gallon of any fluid. You shouldn't do that.
I didn't say
hour.
I was going to knock it out. I'm just drinking like I normally drink.
Oh, no. Bullshit.
So
oh, bullshit. I've known you for so long.
So look at this. Look, Bert shaved and
he looks worse than I thought.
You gotta grow your beard back. Bart, you gotta grow it back.
Gosh.
Dude, what
look
do you think?
At that mouth, huh?
Those fucking little chiclets. He's got one big one, though.
No, that yeah, that's a trident stick in the front.
Yeah, that thing, that's how you start your apples right there. you got that. You can get anything going. Whoa.
Oh,
whoa.
Man. I think he has two or three on the bottom, and that's it.
It is amazing that this guy decides that he is going to motivate people.
Yes.
To strive to be the best.
He's not even motivated to get his teeth fixed.
He's not motivated for shit. His only motivation was to turn a camera on, but that's the
right.
only thing.
Right. Right. He's clearly got a lot of things to work
and
on.
And he got really fired up in this thing, you know?
Yeah, he's real fat and sweaty.
If you do not thrive.
Thrive or strive?
To be the best.
Oh, right. If we had some more teeth, we know the answer.
Because you're supposed to strive to be the best.
But when you're missing teethuses,
then you thrive to be the best?
You thrive.
If you do not thrive.
You're right.
To be the best.
Yeah.
If you do not push yourself to be the greatest, you will accomplish nothing.
That's true, actually.
How badly do you want it?
Huh.
How badly do you want it?
Oh my God. Who's this guy? Where did you find him?
I just found him on Instagram, and
yeah.
I don't know. He motivated the shit out of me that day. I was sitting around in the hotel in wet nutsack, and I go, I'm going to hit the gym.
Yeah, and the dentist.
Yeah.
Did you make an appointment?
I bought some floss right away. Jesus.
Not as bad.
Look, there's a lot to go over, but we should point out the fact that we got new shirts on. Dude, we did
it.
We did it. This has been a dream, and we finally
achieved it.
Made it happen. We're wearing double pipe classic shirts. Look at that design.
Very rare.
Very rare
very
as
rare.
The tag. And this is no shit. You know, Top Dog obviously contributed to this design coming along and sharing his expertise on them.
Yeah.
And then last week, after we recorded the show,
right.
we had lunch downstairs, sat down, and if you go to Christina's Instagram, you can see me. I got a thumb up and a thumb down.
Yeah, it happened.
I had a double pipe classic in front of her, and I mean, I watched you cry for an
right,
hour.
Right, it was so special.
It was.
And our son was there to witness.
You know that I looked at the photo, and I realized I'm in shock in the photo.
Right.
Like, I go like, oh, like you can see my face. I'm like,
Right.
What just happened? What just
happened?
Right,
and I noted the time even on the Instagram post
Yeah.
That it happened.
It was incredible.
Really incredible. And what's funny is that it, you know, like with all Double Pipe classics, it's a surprise. Yeah. You know, you think you're just going to burp or you're just going to fart and then it happens.
Yeah.
And it, you know, and it's like, you don't really, yeah, that's right after it happened.
Look at your post.
Right. 3:17 PM, June 20th, 2016. I witnessed Tom having a Double Pipe classic. They're extremely rare and you can't force them.
Yeah.
You can't make it rain.
I mean, look at that shock.
Yeah.
I'm like, did that just...
And look how thin you are there. Hmm. Look how skinny you look.
Oh, I know some people that don't look like that. But yeah, that is, that's the moment, man.
That was right after it happened.
Yeah. So we now have Double Pipe Classic shirts. They are at yourmomshousepodcast.com. They're also in my store, tomsegura.com. If you go to the shop page, it's also there. And it's just really exciting, man.
Now, do you remember... I remember you were kind of leaning over because you were.
I just.
Like,
dude,
how did it happen?
It was such a magical moment. I mean, we had. I think it was towards the end of lunch.
Yes.
We ordered sushi.
Yeah.
And finished.
Wrapping it up.
Yeah. And I remember feeling. What did I feel coming first? I think I felt the fart brewing. And then.
Right. Because that's when you leaned over to express it.
And as I leaned over.
Yeah.
Came out of the top at the same time.
Yeah.
And it wasn't, you know, that's the thing. It's not burp fart. It's not fart burp. It's
right.
Both.
Right.
Boom. That's why it's so rare. That's why we wrote very rare. Because gas usually chooses a path. It goes, I'm going up or I'm going down.
Right. And the thing that happens with every Double Pipe classic is that you don't immediately know it happened because you're in shock.
Yeah.
So when you did it.
Hence that
right,
look. Yeah.
Like you did it and we both went, that was a Double Pipe.
Yeah. Yeah.
They are so rare. And it was so neat that it happened right after we had just discussed it. And
yeah.
I don't know. It's
really
special.
The main thing for me too is that it's really even more rare, if I can say so, to have a witness for one.
Yeah.
A lot of times you're alone and
yes.
It's like, oh, you did?
Yeah,
you
right.
Know, sure. Yeah.
Yeah.
But when you have a witness, there's no one can take it away from you.
That's true.
You know?
It's like your college education and your Double Pipes.
Yeah. Yeah. People are there for it. So it was really, really something. And we're very excited. We're very,
very excited.
We've wanted a Double Pipe Classic shirt. And then this, this is the one, man. This is it's really
very
nice,
rare.
Really nice material.
It's soft, too. It fits like a glove. I love it.
Shipping is included for all domestic offers. That's true.
A Double Pipe. What's great about this shirt too is that it's on the down low. You know, only other mommies are really gonna get it.
Right. And it doesn't say like fart on it.
No. It's kind of subtle. So people have to like somebody.
When I picked it up from the shirt place, the guy was asking me, he's like, is this like a X Games event or something?
Really? Did you explain it to him?
Yeah.
What did he say?
It's like, oh.
Better than X Games.
Yeah.
We should send this to Tony Hawk.
Oh, right. Right. Pipe, right? So they're like, yeah.
You have half the pipes. Pipe.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, similar, well, but not really.
I bet he's probably like, I wish I could have one of those. I wish I could have a Double Pipe Classic. Maybe you will, sir. If you live long enough, if you pray hard enough.
You just have to live long enough. I think that is the secret. And don't force it. Just be open to what happens.
I want to say I had one in 2015. And I want to say I don't remember when it happened.
I don't think you did.
Maybe 2014.
2014, yes.
So that's how long. You know, it's 2 years, man.
Yeah.
Yep. Anyways.
You know what my favorite is? It's just because I think you're really lucky in that you married someone who thinks that burps and farts are super funny.
Mm-hmm.
But I really like when you burp and make a sound like you just did. Like when you go, yep, or like, just especially when you do it in front of your mom.
Yeah. Oh,
when
really
we're in Florida
her.
Or
yeah,
when
yeah.
she's around, yeah. she's like, ah.
It's just coming, you know. She's
I know.
Coming. Yeah, yeah.
I love it because she gets mad at you for burping and then she gets mad at me for laughing at your burp. So it's like we get a double upset, Charo.
Yeah, I'm going to try to get her in here just to talk to her for a while. And
yep.
Yeah. I'll do some burps in front of her just to get her to go, ah.
Because no matter how
please.
Much I hate you,
yeah.
no matter how much I hate you or we're fighting, if you go, yep, it makes me laugh every time.
No matter how much I hate, look how you
like
leave.
If we're fighting or something, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? No.
No.
No?
No. So
who's this old guy?
This guy, you're gonna fall so in love with, I promise. You are. So Toothy, old Toofy Toofs, got me thinking about motivation. Yes. And then I also saw this guy, oddly enough, also on Insta, saw part of this.
Yeah.
And so I had Blue Band pull it. Just give him a listen. His name is Daniel Pena, and he's a businessman who also is a coach, like a mentor to people in the business world. Okay. And this is at one of his seminars.
You know, he just dumbed down and shut off that part of his brain and just follow the steps. You don't need fucking case studies. You have a fucking template. Yes. You have a motherfucking script that a fucking monkey can read. That Alex wants a fucking case study because he wants to know the shit behind it because he's stupid. And that's why he's fucking poor. You don't need any motherfucking case study. How many fucking times do I have to say? You have the fucking script. I said, don't change a fucking word on the script.
Okay.
Not a comma.
I love it.
If it's got misspelled fucking words, send it out misspelled. The last thing you fucking need is a fucking case study. What is that? This is why you're fucking poor. This is why the cocksuckers watching this on YouTube are so fucking poor.
Again, I want more. Is there more?
Oh, there's so much more.
The $50 million man.
That's why?
Yeah. Wait, there's.
God, I love. You're right. I love this guy.
Told you, that's
why you're fucking poor. Oh, it's so good.
So this guy is pretty. Well known
Pena.
Pena for not biting his tongue very often.
That's my kind of bro.
Yeah.
Oh, I love this guy.
Hanging out with losers. Wasting your time.
Correct.
You.
Okay. Show me your friends and I'll show you your future.
That's one of your top.
It is.
Three pieces.
Show me your friends and I'll show you your future. You want to know why you're all fucked up? Just look at the fucking bums you hang around with.
I swear, this is everybody in my family.
I know it is.
Eastern Bloc shit, dude. Yeah. Are you sure his last name isn't like Bajitsky?
Can't you?
Wadowski.
You picture him like you're at the table.
This is my dad.
And him telling you.
Yes, this is the shit I heard growing up.
By the way,
yes.
This is one of, by the way, and I'm not a coach, obviously, for people.
Yeah.
This is one of life's great truths.
Yeah.
If you are in a place right now where you're like, man, like shit's just not working out.
Yeah.
I wish I had more going. I'm really bummed out about this.
Yeah.
Look who you're hanging out with.
It's true. He's right.
It's always the truth.
You're hanging out with losers, man. Yeah.
You want to know why you're all fucked up? Look at the fucking bums.
I can watch this
and
all
I show
day.
You your future. You want to know why you're all fucked up? Just look at the fucking bums you hang around with.
I wish I could play that for so many people I know. I really do.
Everybody needs to hear this guy. This guy's
friends,
the right. He's
I have
the best
family
guru.
Members that need to see
Everybody
this.
Everybody needs to see this guy. He's right.
He's totally
This
right.
is the guru. This is who people should be listening to.
Yeah.
Not fucking Oprah and Dr. Phil. This is the guy. He's right. You're hanging out with fucking losers.
Yeah.
Play more.
Okay. I knew you'd love him.
I love this guy. I got to get him on that.
This is why you're fucking poor.
Okay, sorry. That was just an ISO. Did you ISO? No, you just ISO'd this one thing.
What's his name again?
Daniel Pena.
Man, yeah. I gotta look this
You're
guy.
A cunt, Brian, not me.
You have that whole thing in here? The whole thing or no?
Holy shit.
On the cheat sheets there? Okay.
Oh, I must know more. So is he like a billionaire or something?
Well, I don't know.
Businessman?
There's
coach.
Yeah.
Oh, I love him so
Let's
much.
See if this is the one I want to play for you.
Your friends are fucking losers. You're a loser. He's right. He's right. You're hanging out with losers, you're going to be a fucking loser.
Yeah.
And hang out with winners.
Man.
Holy shit. I used to hear this growing up all the time. This is the way my parents used to talk to me. I mean it. My dad would say the same thing.
And sometimes we exchange emails and I'm like, why does Dan have to be such a cunt? Why does he have to push it? Why does he have to always want to
win? No, I'm being just the opposite of a cunt.
That's right.
You're a cunt, Brian, not me.
explain.
Yeah.
You're weak.
And you're showing
and
me
you,
I'm weak.
And you want these people to like you.
And you're telling me I'm weak on that email. Because you love me, because you care.
Yeah, absolutely. Thank you very much.
Uh-huh.
God, this guy's related to me.
He's crazy.
Yeah.
And you can be more than you are. If these little cunts think that you're something now, I see you 1,000 times more.
Yeah.
See, they have low standards, these fucking weenies to watch this fucking thing. I don't. I know what you can be. They think you're a big fucking deal. I know you're not.
I love it so much.
And down deep inside, Brian, you know that I'm closer to being right than they are.
Oh, my God.
You don't agree with me 100%, fine. But you know I'm closer to being right than they are. You're not the all end all shit. Who gives a fuck? In the cosmos of time, you are not a fart in the wind.
No one is.
Exactly.
Well, won't you always want me to be 1,000 times better?
Absolutely.
Years from now?
Just like if my daughter, who's a British citizen.
What?
This is HD Buttercup. Sorry, that British line of furniture.
Oh, really?
Liked, that's the showroom it's in.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying?
So you think they went to a furniture store to do this?
Yeah. This is that British furniture company we like.
Okay.
Probably. It's all the same company furniture. Anyway, that was really exciting.
Yeah.
I really like this guy. Does he have a book I can read?
I don't know if he has a book. I have more audio of him, though.
Oh, absolutely.
Yeah, he's really spectacular.
They think you're a big fucking deal. I know you're not.
Okay. You're a cunt.
And talk to me about for those first few days, what have been the reactions from people? Do you get people that want to leave? Do you get people that want to cry?
He lives in a castle in Scotland.
Oh, cool.
Daniel Pena does.
Good for him.
Yeah, he has some other residents.
He's a fucking winner, that's why.
Yeah, and people pay a lot of money to go and sit in like that room that you heard him telling people you're fucking poor?
Yeah.
That's at his castle.
I love it.
So these are people who, you know, his story is that he turned, I think it was $8 into $430 million.
Right? Wow.
So he was some high-ranking executive in an oil company. And I don't know. He's been a coach for business people, but he just has this persona, you know.
To some people, because you can tell not to push him. I mean, you must have to give a little bit or not push a little bit.
No. Well, okay, we've had people piss their pants. We've had people pass out.
Yeah.
We've had people shit their pants. A partner in a big four accounting firm shit his pants. The person that passed out was a psychiatrist. We've got Harvard medical doctors. We've got...
why would they pass out? Why would they pass
out? I mean, they just did.
Oh, okay.
Just the stress.
The stress of hanging out with this
with
guy.
With you. Yeah, imagine that. The stress of being around me makes people pass out, piss, and shit themselves.
God, what a psycho. I love it.
Has anyone ever said, fuck you, Dan Pena, I'm walking out the door?
No, I've thrown a couple out, but nobody's ever said that. No, I take that back. One Romanian walked out the door because he said I was making fun of him, calling him a gypsy, a Roma. But then when we came back in the afternoon, he was sitting in the library. And I thought, I thought you left. And he says, no, you were right. You're right.
I'll be the first if I walk.
Yeah, if you walk, you'll be well. There'll be plenty of cunts here, but you may be the first cunt to walk out.
I got to get to Scotland, geez.
Dude, I want
to
sign up for this seminar.
Me too.
So bad. And then be like, can we simulcast this on your mom's house podcast?
So good. I got to go. Can you please send me?
I wonder how much it is.
Let's find out. Let's go.
I bet it's a lot of money.
Oh, that's true. Shit. Maybe I could do a Kickstarter.
Now, you put a number by every fucking person that you emailed, Skype fucked, tweet fucked, link fucked. And what's one of your goals on this other side of the paper that have anything to do with?
Hilarious. Yeah. Lincoln.
Link fucked.
Because it's for fucking losers. He's right.
I don't give a fuck about these pee heads watching this thing like me. You said they're either going to love you or hate you. Mm-hmm. I knew which one it would be. All my life, I've been this way. And all my life, people love me and respect me.
Yeah.
Wow.
If you're in a foxhole, who do you want in the fucking foxhole with you, Brian? You want some mealy-mouthed cunt, politically correct asshole? Or you want somebody that's going to rip their head off and shit down their neck?
I'm in love.
I told you.
I think I'm in love, Tom. I'm sorry.
And I'll tell you, I'm fucking love this guy.
Me too. I listen to everything he says.
Yeah.
God damn. I wish he taught a school. Seriously, I'd send my kid to his school. to teach them not to be fucking pussies.
Right.
Like today, the kids, you know, these kids are fucking mollycoddled. It's old school. I love it. I love old school craziness like this.
It's great.
Oh, it makes me so happy. Doesn't it make you feel safer in the world when there are people like him?
Well, you need guys like that.
No, you do. You need like no nonsense, normal people.
Yeah.
God, that made me feel like I was home again. I liked it.
It feels real familiar, right?
No, it's my parents. Everyone talks like this where I came from. To have, honestly, like to have like Americans who are nice and stuff, that freaks me out. That makes me feel uncomfortable.
But when a guy's like...
this guy?
Yeah.
This could be my mom.
Yeah.
Mom and dad.
So it just feels so familiar.
Feels right at home, man.
Yeah.
Ah, oh, felt good.
There's one here. I don't see it in here, but he did...
I love him so much.
He did an interview in a car. Do you remember that one?
Oh, that's my baby next one.
No. He did an interview in a car where this guy's like, how's it going? He goes, great. Sun shines out of my asshole. And the guy's like, all right. You can tell no one's prepared for him.
Yeah. He is crazy.
Yeah. Yeah. He's great.
Love him. Oh, man.
Yeah. He's got quite a mouth. It does sound like your family.
Yeah.
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 It's really interesting.
My dad talked. My mother would talk like this more.
Yeah.
This guy's probably mentally ill, too. I'm serious.
You might be right. Hey, do you want a Persian lady voicemail update?
I would love one. So, I fucking love one, Tom. She's a fucking loser.
You fucked up. You fucking bums.
Quit hanging out with losers.
So here's the here's the voicemail from last week. Just
okay,
so you know.
Salome.
Hello, سلامه. این پلاستیکا که بهت گفتم و گروسری تو میریم این بگا مثلا گوجه فنگی میذاری و نمیدونم سبزی میذاری و اینا همه رو من الان دارم به درختام. او مای گاد اصلا دیگه این سمورای اصلا لا کامبود دیار نات گوینگ در آب در عدال هم تا او مای گاد تمام انجیره من رو میخورم من قد هرس میخورم تمام اون شاتوت های من رو میخورم الان دیگه اصلا دست نمیزنن سو گود نو اصلا دیستاتیه شدن برو کلی از این بگا بردار منم باید برم همین کار کنم همه تمام شاخهات رو بزن از اون پایین دو سه تا من زدم اصلا اینا دیگه دیستاتیه شدن مادر جنده اوکی دیگه پس تا تسون
Jesus.
Oh my God.
So.
Oh my God.
We're always waiting for the, you know, the scoop on what's really going on here.
Oh my God.
Because we know that this goes deep, you know. I mean, this.
Of course.
These messages never stop coming in. I want to credit. Do you know who left this? Who set this in?
No.
No. Oh my God.
Okay. Well, we got an actual person, and I'm sorry we're not crediting you correctly, who sent in an MP3. So he actually says what she said.
That's so much better.
Yeah, it's great. So this is what she is saying. Okay.
Hello, Salome. Those plastic bags I told you about, put those ones that you get tomatoes and herbs from the supermarket. Put them on your trees. Oh my God, those chipmunks, they're not going up there at all. They keep eating my figs and keep worrying that they're going to eat all my blackberries. Now they're not touching them at all. I feel so good. They've all disappeared now. Hurry up and grab those bags, and I've got to do the same. Put them all over on your branches. Start from the bottom and work your way up to the top. Those mother sluts have all disappeared now. Okay, talk to you soon.
That's amazing.
Wow,
dude.
Thank you so
much.
Keep sending these in, please.
That's so great.
Wait, this is so much better than us reading it.
Of course. Yeah.
So how
she, by the way, so might be really mentally ill. Start from the bottom. This lady has grocery bags all over trees. You understand?
Like, how horrible must that look in her house?
Yeah, you know, you got to give some to the animals. That's the way it works. Like animals get away with that.
So she's choking squirrels. They're probably suffocating.
No, the squirrels are just like, oh, thanks a lot. Like, that's how I live. I eat your fruits.
She's so funny. So she's got a crazy tree with bags on it right now.
Oh, yeah.
What a fucking nut.
Yeah, absolutely.
Immigrants, man, they don't give a fuck. They do everything crazy style.
By the way.
That's so funny, Salome.
You have a lot. There's a strong... there's a strong backlash against you in the water championship.
Are we going to fucking go there now?
Yeah, I think we should. So we put a poll out there.
Oh, fuck off.
To see.
Oh, these losers? A bunch of fucking losers answered your fucking poll.
It's final. It's over now. 69% Tom, 31% Jeans.
Why don't you ask fucking Daniel Pena what he thinks about your tweeting and your LinkedIn?
A lot of people feel like, you know, that you can't be trusted for a number of reasons.
What did I do?
Well, here's an example. Tom is the best. He's not a big fat liar the non-main mommy, 808, remember?
That wasn't a lie. That was just misinformation. I did not know. I didn't deliberately lie.
Tom, obviously, bigger gulps.
Well, that's because you're bigger. You're just a bigger animal than me. Big, stupid, stinky, dumb bear.
The water champion drinks more water.
Not necessarily because you drink less frequently than I do, even though I sip all day. Okay.
How is this even
a debate? The tortoise and you're the hare.
How is this even a question? Tom's taking bigger sips.
No.
Hence,
this is the tortoise and the hare, babe.
Physical evidence. Your Honor, look at the physical evidence, Your Honor.
This is what's known as it's a long race. It's a marathon that I run, okay? You do your sprints, and I'm in for the long haul, bitch. The tortoise wins.
Yeah, it says Pajinski is the sip champ. Okay. But pure water intake, it's buns all day.
Go fuck yourself and your stupid fucking Twitter followers.
You know what? I actually feel like maybe...
Okay.
Maybe you agree with them. I think you agree with them.
No, I'm not even gonna...
I think you... Maybe
I'm listening to this
vote that I am the water champion. I think you think I'm the water champion. I think here's the evidence.
Are you hydrating after your boxing?
Of course, look at me. I have two.
Okay.
I have a liter and a half of water.
You gotta hydrate, soldier.
You know, hydrating isn't just for graduates.
Florida graduates. People want to hear that.
Mm.
That's so gross. You drink like an animal. That was one swig for Tommy.
Mm.
That amount that you just drank, like I could never do that in one swoop. You drink a bear. Okay. So what is, I just said that now and that's historical. So what?
So you're saying, Tom, you're the water champion.
I did not say that. I said I could not do that because I don't weigh whatever it is you and Bert collectively weigh. I don't have big stomachs like you and Bert.
So you're not drinking enough water.
No, I am. I'm just, it's a slow burn. What did I tell you? It's a marathon. You're sprinting. That's what fucking dilettante water drinkers do like yourself.
No. You could never drink this much water.
Well, let's...
Over the course of a few
days. Your Honor.
Maybe a few days.
Allow me to introduce my evidence from Twitter. Jay at Big Jay Savage writes, if Tom had enough water, he wouldn't be DJ Dadmouth. It's because you're so dehydrated and smelly from drinking coffee and not enough water. That's why you're DJ Dad Mouth.
No, that's not true.
Okay.
That's not true. I'm the water champion. First of all, I appreciate you voting me the water champion. I'll never let you down.
Okay.
And I'll continue to drink far more water than Christina could ever drink.
This poll is rigged. I don't believe for a minute that the listeners...
So you're saying at the end of a day...
You're rigged.
At the end of a day, though, who has drank more water? This is nonsense.
I swear to God I do. Can I tell you why? Mm. Last night before we went to bed, I had by my bedstand 2 full Avion bottles. What did you have next to your bed to drink at night? Tom, now you're just showing off. This is all for the cameras. You know that he never does this when the cameras are off. Tom, how much water did you have next to your bed last night?
I guess it was like a liter and a half.
No, wrong. A tiny little shitty cup. A mug.
You could never drink as much water as
me. Okay. I just had another report in from someone who went to see you in West Nyack.
Okay.
That Tom didn't drink water the entire time he was on stage. And that's at least an hour that had gone by.
That's nonsense.
No, it's true.
That's such nonsense.
It's on Twitter.
First of all, I'm not up there just gulping water on stage.
Well, you must be severely dehydrated because you're sweating
I do drink on stage.
You do your routine where you pretend to have sex with a stool and you like Bruce, you have the towel, you're always sweating.
Yes, but I drink so much water after sets. As soon as I get off stage, I drink... I don't know.
Because you're dehydrated severely.
No, it's from all the talking. I'll drink like 60 ounces after a show.
Okay, well, those of us that hydrate properly consistently throughout the day bring the water on stage.
You need to work on your concession speech. That's it.
Okay.
You need to be like, I competed, I lost.
No.
And your nominee is Tom Segura.
Can I send you a photograph? I sent you a photograph.
Yes.
I'd like to pull it up right now, Your Honor.
Okay, this is the photo. That's what you're saying?
That's what the word photograph is short. Photo is a shortened version of photograph.
What the fuck is this?
This is a picture of me when I was born. Could you please pull it up as evidence of what's happening? What does it show you? What was I doing the minute I came out of my mother? What am I doing?
Yeah, you're holding a bottle of water.
That's right.
I understand. This is so unnecessary.
Why?
To go this route.
It's photographic evidence. This is me being born.
Look,
and I already have water in my hands.
This right now you're.
I don't believe it, and I'm going to fight this verdict.
You're fucking Bernie Sanders right now.
I'm not Bernie Sanders.
I'm Hillary. I have the nomination.
No, you're not. You're George Bush.
No, I have the votes.
Junior.
I have the votes.
You're a Bush Junior. This is Florida. I demand a recount.
Are in.
I demand a recount.
Yeah.
This is the Chad. This is the hanging Chad. I don't know who these people are.
1% of the 1%. And it's not enough water. That's you. That's you right now.
I will give you this puny fake Twitter
fake.
Loser victory.
Is it fake?
Get of course, this free blue what? Band rigged
the,
it.
Was it fake? The voting that we just
blue band rigged.
No, that was real.
I don't care. Listen,
it was like 1,200 people voted.
1,200.
I don't care. Listen, I'll give you your stupid loser Twitter poll. Like
wow,
Daniel,
you're insulting everybody.
Pena would say
1,348 votes. You lost.
I don't. Okay, you know what? I'll give you this bullshit victory today.
Why is it a bullshit victory?
Because it's fucking wrong, bro.
You lost.
They don't know the truth.
You're a fucking bum. You know why you're a fucking loser? Because you drink water with losers.
Okay. At least I drink water.
You know why you're all fucked up?
This is all for show, guys. His bullshit water.
Okay.
Jug.
Okay.
Which Blue Band picked up for you on the way in. Don't think I don't fucking notice that. Because that shit was cold. It wasn't in our fridge.
No.
Wasn't in our fridge.
It's not true.
Hello.
I always have.
Who
this.
Gets the sparklets in the house? Who makes sure that shows up? Who orders bottled water so that you can hydrate properly?
It's so sad to see somebody just like treading water that they can't drink.
All right, there's a video I have of you in West Nyack.
This is for now too. Okay.
Well, I'm just letting you know that someone saw you in West Nyack,
and they took
footage of you. You didn't know you were being watched.
Okay, here we go.
I'm going to pepper spray you in the face. That's what I'm going to do to you. Go away. No, get away from the kayak. Get away from that kayak. Bear, you're breaking it. You're breaking my kayak. Why are you breaking my kayak? What am I gonna
do? Why are you doing that, Tom?
Stop it! Bear, stop that! Bear, please stop! Please stop, Bear! It's the end of September! Why are you here? You're supposed to be asleep! Bear! Please stop breaking my things! It's not even food! It doesn't even taste good!
Yeah. Why'd you eat that lady's kayak?
I want this lady, I've never said this, but I want her to get eaten by a bear badly.
She's trying to reason with the bear. That's the best part.
If that camera could have kept rolling and he just devoured her.
I know. Like that funny documentary we watched.
That hilarious doc.
Timothy Treadwell.
That's right.
That's how I knew you and I would be married.
I thought he was retarded.
You and I went to see that documentary when we were just dating.
Yeah.
And the Timothy Treadwell, what was it called? Grizzly Man.
Yeah.
And we saw it in the theater.
Who was the narrator, the director, remember the German guy?
Werner Herzog. Werner.
Yeah.
And there is a part where the guy goes, yeah, we just thought Timothy was retarded. And you and I laughed out loud together.
And no one else did.
No one else in the theater. And when he got mauled, we were laughing.
We were dating. That was a dating period. Yeah.
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 Yeah. And I was like, this guy.
The whole time he was talking about his dumb bears.
Yeah.
On that, like, he'd make those videos where, like, this fucking
dummy.
Idiot. Yeah. And then Verna was like, there was a special connection between
no connection.
Him and the bears.
None.
Yeah.
The connection was the bear was going to eat you.
Yeah. This guy was like, this is my little fox, Foxy.
Yeah.
He had one of those things, like a fucking 80-year-old woman that gets a bird and calls it, like, Birdie, you know?
Yeah.
And he was like,
hey, Foxy.
This is Bear and Foxy.
So dumb. He was living on a bear reserve, and he thought he was protecting the bears. from...
I will fight for these bears.
Yeah. So he was a crazy person.
Totally a crazy
camping
person.
Out with dangerous bears, and then he got eaten by them.
Yeah.
What a shocker.
Yeah. It's
big dummy.
Big fucking dummy.
Hanging out with losers, and he got eaten by them.
Absolutely. Let's get into this real quick. Update on Bert and his fatness.
Oh my God.
No, so.
Never. It just keeps morphing into something better and better every week.
I think, you know, we owe it to the listeners and everybody to play a lot of Bert.
Yeah.
You know, people think that we're, you know, we're best buddies, man.
Yeah.
And I think people need to know that it's not a one-sided thing. So
right.
We're bringing you the other side of the coin. Here's Bert on AJ Hawk's podcast, The Hawkcast, kind of filling him in on some of this stuff.
In confidence, I tell him I'm the fattest I've ever been, and fucking Buns shares that with everybody. God damn it, Bert looks like Gerard Depardieu.
That's right, that was a few months ago.
But to be fair, I want to say this. He did not say it in confidence. He started making videos. No. I'm the fattest I've ever been.
Right. It was very public about
this. Yeah, and he was weighing himself on videos.
Yeah.
Saying that, so it wasn't, and that's the, Bert has a way of twisting, you know,
the reality.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, so. He was making, I'm so fat, I'm trying to lose weight.
My agent called at one point and was like, hey, you're trending right behind Kesha and Amy Schumer in fat shaming. Georgia, my 12-year-old, pulled me aside and goes, Daddy, people say really mean things to you online. And I go, baby, it's not real. It's not, the internet's not real. I go, in my head, I go, they're my fans too. But then part of me is like, are they? And now here's the thing.
God, I look so really fat there right now.
Is I am overweight. Like, I am the second fattest I've ever been in my life.
The second fattest?
Second fattest.
Oh.
Only second to the time I told Tom I was the fattest in this campaign.
Oh, man.
And he's drinking. just hammering booze during the thing.
Oh, God.
Bert. Like, Liam's got to love this.
Doing this, like, Bert looks like Gerard Depardieu. Apparently. Apparently we have some similarities. I don't know.
Remember that naked? It was the nude photo.
The nude photo. Where they did look. He has a similar.
bloated, distended, yeah. Swollen.
Now, Gerard is a little bit bigger. I'll give him that. But
not by much.
But not by a lot.
Maybe 5 pounds.
Yeah. It's like, you know, I'm 6 feet. You're 6'1". Like that kind of thing. Right. You know? Yeah.
I think they put some memes together or would put your face on his body.
Some memes. There are apparently a lot of fat Mexican babies that look a lot like me.
What is that supposed to mean?
Oh, man. I don't know.
It's, you know, Tom and I find it more funny than not, especially when like a publicist is like, hey, you're not getting a lot of good feedback on the show. And I was like, really? She's like, all anyone can say is how fat you are. Like, oh, my God. No, that's not real.
Travel Channel. Like, why are people saying you're so fat?
What it is they don't technically fat shame the fattest people. They fat shame the people who are on the fence of like, I know I'm fat, right. But no one really says it to me.
He's right.
But he's not just talking about us. I think he's talking about fat shaming in general.
In general, yeah, he's right about that.
Yeah,
yes.
People get fat shamed.
We're on the cusp of obesity.
Or people who you know shouldn't be fat. That's how it goes. I mean, that's right. All the stuff. Like when I get, I've gotten a lot of fat comments over the years. It's people who are like, you're a piece of shit. You shouldn't be this fat. Not like you're 400 pounds. They're just like, right. Stop being lazy.
Because those cases that are like well into 400 or 500, like that's a medical.
Yeah, and people usually, you don't see people bombard those people with comments.
Because they already feel like shit, I imagine, when you're that big.
Yeah.
Shit goes down, and I just want to eat.
Look at AJ's face.
Yeah. And that's a guy who doesn't AJ's get like, it. Why are you so
what
fat?
Are you talking about?
I want to get this to stop.
I'm fit.
I want to get skinnier than Tom. I am skinnier than Tom. No,
he is not.
I'm skinnier than Tom.
He is not skinnier than Tom. No, look what good shape AJ is in, by the way.
Oh, my God. Remember when he was here?
Yeah.
And I go, hey, we weigh the same. Does it look different?
He's in such good shape.
No, he's never been out of shape.
Right.
You know what I mean? That's a lifetime of never being out of shape.
Well, how much does Bert actually weigh? Like, what are you guessing?
What do I think he weighs?
Yeah.
I don't know. 50?
I don't know. I don't know boys' weights is what
I'm saying.
Yeah,
no, probably like 310.
310. Yeah. And what do you think AJ
now
weighs?
Now you're putting all this on me. Now I feel bad. I don't know if many people. I haven't heard much from
him. Look how great
he looks. He had me do a little promo.
Wait.
Now
I feel bad. The promo that he did when he was on Charge to the Game.
Look at Bert's reaction when he finds out, though. This is the best.
So now that you're putting all this on me, now I feel bad. I don't know if many people. I haven't heard much from it. He had me do a little promo.
Bert
falls out of his chair.
Oh, Bert Chrysler.
Burnt Chrysler.
Burnt Chrysler.
Yeah. There's more.
Sorry, look, but how old is AJ?
He's probably 32, 33.
But doesn't he look amazing?
Yeah, you keep saying
it. He looks 22. I'm saying, you know why I keep saying that?
Yeah.
In relation to bloated alcoholic Bert is what I'm saying.
No, of course. He looks amazing. He's a professional athlete. He's,
right. But that's clean living. That's not drinking wine every night.
But that's also like being in, like he, you know, started playing sports probably like in, you know, elementary school.
Right.
And literally as the 32-year-old man has never stopped.
Wow.
So that's being like
in
on
shape.
Sports teams, like it never ended.
But that's what I'm saying. Remember in Highlights magazine, Goofus and Gallant?
Yeah.
One's doing the wrong thing, one's doing the right thing.
That's definitely this.
And it's so apparent who's doing the right thing here.
Yeah. Oh, it's all Yeah.
That latest vlog he did was so damn funny. There's a moment if you can go to his I think it's his YouTube page, Tom Segura. There's a moment where he gets on a scale, and he just looks down, looks at the camera, and goes 200. And I know how far away he is from 200.
And you guys should watch that vlog. It's great. Blue Band.
Where is it
shot
on?
It and direct and edited. It's on Tom Segura's. Go to YouTube. It's the Tom Segura YouTube page.
Hilarious.
It's called The Fat
I said
Blog.
To my therapist, I go, if I had a nickel for every time I said, it's a joke, guys, it's a joke. And then you say it so much that you start going, is it a joke?
Like, yeah.
Is this a joke? Are they my fans?
They are. Yeah, I think it's love,
people
Bert.
People love them.
Yeah.
Some people, look, I've gotten a little bit of the reversal. Some people are really cutting and like mean. You're like, Jesus, you know?
Yeah.
I've gotten a few of those. But most people are kind of clever.
Well, look, this is what comics do. They shit on each other all the time. This is part of the, it doesn't mean anything to us.
Yeah, no.
Just so
he fucking called me and he goes, hey man, like I got to do something because I'm starting to feel bad. And I go, don't. That's I go, true. Tom, don't do anything. I can't have you.
It'll make
come
it worse.
Out. I can't have you come out the front door when I'm in a fight with like my mom in an apron and be like, guys, split it up or I'm going to have to call your mom, you know?
Yeah.
And so I go, Tom, we got to take this to the end. You got to ride this all the way to the fucking ground. And if it means our careers, it means our fucking careers. But we're taking this all the way to the end.
I did. I felt bad. But then there's
and,
but,
and my only goal right now is to beat Tom, is to be skinnier than Tom.
Oh, wow. Is that really, you think he's really going to, how long do you think that's going to last? Until he goes on the road again?
Oh, man. Yeah.
And then he has to drink?
Well, he never is off the road, so I'll always stay ahead of him.
Of course.
Because even like,
of course.
I'm on the road, and you know, I tell you my regimen. Like, I call you, I go, you know, I got the show in a few hours, go on the gym.
Yeah.
Spend like an hour there.
Yeah.
Shower. It's never going to
But that takes discipline.
Right. Yeah.
That's FIFO dreaming.
Yeah. He also went on Punch Drunk.
Uh-huh.
And it was really funny with Jason.
Jason Tebow.
Yeah. And he had some pretty funny things there.
You know, every podcast has like a running gags and running jokes. So I didn't
fuck
know.
Fuck the crab feast.
I didn't know what this was. But everyone's like, hey, please ask Bert why he's so fat. And maybe I got 50 of those.
Please ask Bert why he's so fat.
And then Tom was like, hey man, I really am sorry. Like, I didn't mean for it to get this big. And then I was like,
he didn't mean for that it to get that big or you to get that big.
It to get that
big.
Oh,
my bad.
Hilarious.
Oh, man. Yeah, just.
Oh, my God.
And I go, and don't ever forget, you're fucking fatter than me. That's the funniest part of the whole thing, is Tom is like 270, 280.
No way.
And I am not. I am at least 30 pounds lighter than him.
Bullshit.
No way.
No way.
And by the way.
No way.
Even with those numbers aside, body composition wise.
Yes, I agree. You know, Bert's got that hard fat belly.
Yeah, no.
That's a
He's
different
a fat
belly.
Activist. He's got this amazing self-esteem.
unbelievable.
Like the fact that like that I have friends pulling me aside going, I don't think you're fat, when clearly I fucking am. Like I am the second fattest I've ever been.
Oh, that's not supposed to happen.
Like the fact that like that I have friends pulling me aside going, I don't think you're fat, when clearly I fucking am. Like
okay. Yeah, so there's a couple more things I want to play, but obviously he's also admitting that he's very...
Wait, yeah, but Bert's never had a problem admitting that he's fat.
No, I know.
He's always known it and then ignored whatever steps to take to not be so fat.
Right.
You know, there's pictures of him.
235, that's what I shot my special at, was 235.
Okay.
And but shirtless, and oddly enough, still very overweight.
This is the best, is that in the midst of this Bert is fat campaign, he's going to have a special come out. Where he's shirtless.
Right. Oh, it's going to be great.
I mean, there's... Look, I won't even mention it when that happens, but it's going to explode.
Yeah.
Like his
the gut. Fatness.
Has he shed a bunch of pounds yapping at the...
His body will never lose weight. He does not have that kind of body that the weight will just...
That's not true.
Off. That'll never happen.
Yeah.
His only goal is to turn into a power lifter and just get bigger.
Okay. Wow.
Yeah.
Uh-huh. What was I saying before you rudely interrupted me? I forgot.
Sorry.
I completely forgot my thought.
I'm sorry.
God damn it, Tom.
Like, we go out to eat, and you just watch
him. Oh, I bet you do.
Oh, he fucking murders food.
He's really?
Like, oh, yeah. He orders stuff I've never heard of.
Like what?
He's like, he's the first person that introduced me to...
This is makes me laugh so hard. Is his impression of me is so far off.
Yeah.
But his commitment to it is amazing.
Squid okay. pasta.
Oh,
he was okay. Like, we went to this place. He's like, no. You got to get the ink squid pasta, a little bit of shaved, what are the mushrooms, the trussels, truffles.
Truffles.
They're all, you're going to love it. Oh. And I was like, really? He's like, oh, this is the fucking greatest thing. Get one of those. You know what? We're going to get, let me just order for you. And then he just orders two things he wants.
It's terrible.
And do you think he's throwing you under the bus by ordering you a bunch of fatty food so he can keep shitting on you?
Oh, this was a while ago. We went out to, every time we've gone out to eat, he just, I murder booze, he murders food.
Okay, can I finish that sentence? He should say, I murder booze, he murders food, I also murder food.
Yes.
He eats so much.
So much
and
food.
And eats so much faster than anybody I've ever seen in my life.
He inhales his plate by the time I'm in one bite.
That's why he thinks
gone.
Other people are murdering food.
Yeah.
He's gone.
I know. Remember when we went out with the Chryslers right before I delivered Ellis?
Yes.
Literally like a week before.
Yes.
And... there's a video of it, a vlog.
Of course.
Go and look at Bert's vlog.
Yeah.
He orders
so
five
much.
Entrees
yeah.
for himself.
Yeah, yeah.
And then orders all the desserts,
and
remember?
And eats it in like two bites.
And then bottles of wine.
Yeah.
Every one of every dessert. I'm not even exaggerating.
Yeah, yeah.
Go ahead. Oh, look at Bert's vlog.
He keeps making fun of
like
me.
He's not a big drinker. He'll have like a glass of wine like a woman, and then I will drink... I'll go get a bottle, and he'll go, yeah. And then it'd be like my wife. I give him a glass. I drink the rest of the bottle.
Yeah.
And then he orders... Well, you know what? We should get a couple desserts, and we'll just both get two forks. And then you're like, okay. And then he just orders like, then he'll order three.
Peace.
Well, I mean, key lime pie. Who doesn't want it? Key lime pie doesn't make calories.
That's not true. He does that.
And I don't even like sweets, so he just eats them all.
Oh, wow.
Man. God.
Lies. Look at Bert's vlog.
He's
go look at it when he
so hard.
When we all went out to dinner when I was like about to pop.
Yeah.
And. It'll show you. Let the record show that Chrysler ordered five desserts. Bernd Chrysler ordered five desserts, five bottles of wine, and 10 entrees.
Unreal, this guy.
Come on. I think we should really set up some sort of comedy battle royal, like Ari was saying. Now, Sam and Ari are going to fight.
I didn't know that.
But we might be able to get an undercard of you and...
They're going to box.
What are you talking about? Why? Do they have beef?
I think so, but like...
Tripoli?
Yeah, like people don't know that Bert and I don't have any beef.
And there's no animosity.
Not zero.
I think we should really set up some sort of comedy battle royal, like Ari was saying. Now, Sam and Ari are going to fight. But we might be able to get an undercard of you and Segura. Maybe just rounder before you both have fucking heart attacks.
He's so much heavier than I am that I'd be afraid to. Because there's like so much foundation there. You know? Yep. Like he's just thick. Like I'm a light, frisky... 240. He's like a solid 270. Like you can't move that. He is the mountain, and I'm the young gay guy that dances around and almost wins.
Yeah.
He's right though. You're meat and cheese.
Yeah.
You're solid bear.
Come on, this guy.
You're all full
so
bear.
Anyway, so what about AJ Hawk?
He was like, yeah, I feel bad. I might have cut some promos for Segura about how fat you are.
Really?
I go, are you shitting me? Because Segura's two steps ahead of me in all of this.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
All he's got time to do is
But eat, I like how he's also playing it like, hey, man, I'm going to call off the dogs. You're good.
And then he's cutting promos with AJ Hawk.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Oh, shit. Lulling Bert into a false sense of security, huh?
The best, yeah.
I had a 4-egg omelet before I came here.
Did you really?
I got too hungry. Yeah.
So, anyways, the Bert is fat stuff. Look, I don't even push it anymore. I'm just giving you the updates. The main thing I wanted people to know, because I feel like it's not understood by some, most people get it, is that the there's no animosity.
No.
That we are really good friends. We talk almost every day. But people, you know, sometimes I get comments from people that are like, whoa, man, like, I can't believe, like, why are you bullying him? I'm like, I'm not bullying him.
Guys, it's called comedy world.
Yeah. So anyways,
no,
by the way, we've had, you know what? I got to take a piss. I've had so much water.
Oh, that's probably because you're not used to drinking so much water.
No, it's because it's so much more water than you'll ever drink in a week. And I just had it in like 30 minutes.
Why don't you shave the back of your neck too?
Funny. You talk shit. And then you went and peed yourself.
Well, that's because I thought I should. Okay. But I didn't have to go as badly as you did because you're obviously showboating and it's not normal for you to drink this much water.
True. It's totally normal.
What color was it?
What do you think? It's always just the color of
Bullshit.
Water.
Bullshit. I've smelled. You're such a liar. I can't even believe it. I swear, I wish I had smell-o-vision when you and I shower together. And you pee, and it's
that
fucking dark
one
brown.
Day. That was
no,
one...
your pee is brown like the coffee, and it smells of coffee.
One hobo shower.
It's not
shower.
One hobo shower. It's every time you shower with me. You're so disgusting. I swear to God.
This one. Liar.
You're a liar.
Anyways.
So this morning, you made an explosion smoothie.
Well, I should credit, and I regrettably don't remember his name, the chef at Wet Nutsack. Really nice
right.
guy. He knows you. He remembered you.
Oh, good.
Yeah, he's real friendly, and he's like, there's only a few clubs where like the chef will come in the green room and be like, anything you want.
That's so nice,
yeah,
isn't
so
it?
Nice.
Especially because you're such a healthy eater, unlike Burnt
yeah.
Chrysler. You probably were like
but it
salmon.
Does make you feel so welcome and so,
yeah.
you know.
There's a few kitchens like that.
First night, I ordered this chicken dish. It was great. And then, actually, a lot of people were even tweeting me that they're like, thanks for actually have it working at a club where the food is good. Cause
it's nice.
Really good food there. Anyways, then somebody else mentions, they're like, oh, have you had one of his smoothies? And I didn't know what they meant. I thought they were talking about something sweet, you know? Mm-hmm. I'm like, what kind of smoothie? Oh, he just throws a bunch of fruits and vegetables in. I go, oh, I'll try that. Because I literally, on the road, I try to maintain this thing where I go, workout, shower, show.
Right.
You know, because if you do it in that order, it's a good flow.
What time of day do you start it at?
Well, let's say I have a 7 o'clock show. I will try to work out between 4:45. I'll try to start in the gym between 4:45 and 5.
Mm-hmm.
That way you have like a good, however long you want to work out, 30, 40, 60 minutes. And then you're not rushed, so you go back to your room, you take a shower, you don't have to rush the show.
Do you nap before shows anymore?
No,
that's
no,
old.
No. What happens is those workouts give you that energy boost,
right?
So that because a lot of times you drag, you feel lethargic on the road.
Yes.
But if you do your workout right before, take your shower, you get dressed, you kind of feel like, oh, I'm really like awake right now.
Alive, really, yeah.
Yes, alive. Mm-hmm. I'm energized.
Mm-hmm.
And then you arrive at the show. I also like to get picked up very late.
Yes.
So that I can arrive. I don't want to wait at the venue.
It's the worst.
So I do that. I arrive and then it's showtime and it feels great. But the only thing that it becomes kind of hairy then is if you had worked out, you're going to go do your show. You get hungry. You don't want to eat a lot of times comedy club food. So this option, the smoothie, I was like, this is excellent. Anyways, I asked him how he makes it, and he tells me, you know, cucumbers, lime juice. He goes, if you don't have that, maybe if you don't have the cucumber, you use kale, an avocado, apples, and it's just a mix mash of fruits and vegetables.
Right.
So I just asked you to pick it up while I was gone. I fired it up this morning for you, and right away, first of all, I did the... since it was the first time making it, I did the taste test. I go, let me see what it tastes like. After two sips of taste test, I go, I got to take a shit. That was two sips.
Yeah.
An explosion.
Yeah.
Came back. Added a little soy milk, water, because we didn't have ice, so to make it cold, I put cold water in there. And then gave you, you had about what, 3/4 of it? I saw you had some.
Yep. So you gave me a nice, healthy pint glass. Yeah. And here I am like, yeah, this tastes great. It's going down super easy. I'm feeding the kid. Mm-hmm. We're laughing. And then we take Ellis up for his nap. His morning nap, and I'm like, well, why don't you put him down? My stomach hurts a little bit, and I'd already taken my morning shit. Mm-hmm. I drink my coffee in the morning, I shit, and that's usually it for the day. I don't shit anymore. But I felt a rumbling, and I was like, I gotta go.
Yeah, you never
I gotta go.
You never do two in the morning.
Never.
No.
And the pain, the cramping, I was doubled over, and I was like, oh my God. It was a six, a hot six.
Really?
Yeah.
But now
I had to shower immediately. And by the way, the bidet, it wasn't enough.
Right.
Wow. It was back to shit to shower because of the smooth.
Wow. Now, did you discover that because you used bidet, wiped, and then you're like, this isn't enough?
Yeah. So I bidet'd it. I rinsed. I left it extra long, and I went to wipe, and there was still brown on the paper.
Wow.
And I go, it's time for old school.
What a story.
Old school.
Now, do you think, now you don't think obviously that what I made was bad. What do you think? It's so intense?
Or? Yeah, it's not bad. What it is, you've got your kale, and then you put like 10 limes in. Lime juice alone will make me shit.
Right.
Apples. I saw you throw in apples. I saw you, there's high fibrous, and you need something like a banana.
Yeah.
To pull it together. Because there's nothing, or yogurt or something to pull it, because it's all like high fiber, high acidic.
Yeah.
Orange. You had orange in there too. So, I mean, eating one orange alone will make me shit dynamite, like already.
Yeah.
It's got to be tempered, Jeans. You hear me?
So, how should I have done
okay,
it?
Okay, here's what I would do if I were you. Half a banana, a little bit of yogurt, like Greek yogurt. You do your, like a peach, maybe some berries. Blueberry, strawberry, and maybe some kale and cucumber, and that's it. You can't do all acidic,
okay,
fibrous. I mean, sorry, we what?
Okay, I'll tone it down.
I'll go pick up the banana's going to help because the banana binds it. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah. Okay. It was a lot.
That was really intense. I think I lost weight though. Today's my weigh-in day on Weight Watchers, so.
You look great.
I do. You know why?
Right.
Discipline. I don't eat anymore. I just stopped eating. At night. I don't eat at night. I stop eating by 5 o'clock. I try not to eat. Try not to drink a lot too.
Mine, I got to say, it was different. You know, it was still a morning, you know, sort of explosion, but it was a healthier one. It felt good.
When are you going to see the doctor for this IBS?
Oh, I think that's this week.
Yeah.
Oh, shit.
I wish we could live tweet the event. Maybe Blue Band. Can come with you and live tweet. What is it, Tommy? Are you afraid you missed your appointment?
Yeah, I don't want to miss my appointment.
Is it today or tomorrow?
No, it's Thursday.
Okay.
Yeah.
What are you looking at? What?
Nothing. I'm just thinking about it. That's all.
Are you excited to go to the doctor for your IBS?
Of course.
Oh, I have are they going to make you shit there? Like we have to bring in a stool sample? Like with Theo when we have to take Theo and Fancy to the doctor?
This might be he might be like a getting to know you kind of sit down.
Oh.
Where I tell him all the brown stories. What if he goes, tell me about like what you're going through, and I go, could you just download a few episodes of your Mom's House Podcast?
Can I tell you something though?
Hmm.
You need to start making a shit diary and a diet diary so this guy can have a good picture.
Okay.
Because you have, and I don't mean this in a mean way, kind of a skewed memory about what happens to you because you don't really put cause and effect together very well.
You're saying that like I'm a patient who who maybe doesn't have all his brain cells working.
Because you do the same thing over and over and then you get diarrhea and I have to be like, babe, you can't have fried food. It makes you shit. Hmm. You're such a show-off. You're such a show off right now. You're not even that thirsty. You're just doing this for the cameras. They can't even see the truth. This is such fucking bullshit. Are you done?
That's one sip.
But you do that like twice a day.
But you don't understand what it is to be the water champion. It's that I consume so much water.
Okay. Can we talk about something else?
Sure.
We got a request on YouTube from...
Oh, my God.
Are you ready?
Yes.
Nick Hawk. He wanted to get us on copyright infringement and say that we're playing his songs and it should be taken down.
Isn't that amazing?
He didn't like that we weren't talking about his music.
His music. Yeah.
He was very upset. And yeah. Guess what? We fought the law and we won.
Well, we didn't really fight it.
No, we didn't fight it. But we just didn't get taken down.
Yeah.
Because there's no infringement.
Yeah,
we didn't infringe. We explored and discussed. Yeah. It's, and gave him credit for his horrible, horrible music.
Yeah. I mean, he actually filed the copyright claim. This is what they wrote back to us. It was a few episodes ago where we played some of his songs. let me...
Let's play them again, just for old time's sake. I miss them. Well, because I feel like they're all so terrible, but then what's the most terrible Nick Hawk song? I don't know.
Yeah, well...
You know?
Yeah.
Let's what's see. The most unpleasant STD? They're all pretty bad.
Dude. Yeah. I bet he was
What's
really
the worst Steven Seagal movie? They're all pretty terrible. It's that's what you're asking when you ask, what's the worst Nick Hawk song?
His album is really, really atrocious. So... Here is a...
But it's the best worst.
So...
It is the best worst, though.
By the way, a lot of people didn't go to it. They didn't really check it out. No, no. I mean, it says... Here's the comments under it. Hey, mommy's checking in high and tight here. You should stick to fucking old white women. Your career is over. Looks like he hasn't found the cum. Low and loose, no cum in these balls. Thought it was pretty good, high and tight, just like my jeans. All right, so you got a fan.
Okay.
We're not discouraging people from becoming a fan.
I'm breaking a sweat. Can't catch me like I can't catch my breath. Out of shape, you get red.
Oh, shit. So...
mad at me, because I never get spread. My wings are spread. Fly till I die and I'm over the rest. I got a lot more left. You know it's a promise. I'm done making threats. Power up like a Corvette. You never catch up. I take off like a jet.
So embarrassing.
I mean, yeah. Sounds. He's just behind Kendrick Lamar. They're both very talented.
is that your favorite?
That's my favorite song of his. Yes, it is.
Okay.
My favorite intentionally awesome song. There's a bunch of...
What else? Can read me the titles. I've forgotten which is my favorite.
He's got one that's called Everybody's Got a Little Country in Them. I didn't know that.
That sounds like a new jam. Let's give it a listen. Maybe it's better.
I thought he was a rapper.
I thought so too.
No matter where you're from, no matter what you've been through.
I don't think this is Nick Hawk, babe.
Yeah, it is.
You might be from Hong Kong.
Well, this is great.
That's actually really good, Nick.
Yeah, stick to country.
That's the thing. You're just in the wrong lane.
Yeah.
Your accidental song, it's good.
This is good. Well, I like this a lot better.
There's a little country in me. A little country in you.
Hey, this is actually good.
Good job.
Wow.
Good job. Here's another one called...
Yeah, forget the rabbit.
This
what? I mean,
called...
that guy, Vince, beat you in the rap battle. We saw that episode on Gigolos. And look, there's nothing wrong with saying this isn't my genre. This isn't my lane. Pick something you're good at.
Here's
you're great at country.
Step up.
Oh, shit. Man, you know...
Maybe we just need one more to step up. I'm acting like I'm missing something. Everything I have is next to nothing. I don't think about where I'm at, but where I'm going. And I'm 2 fucking seconds away from unloading. I feel being chased by something I can't do.
I'm done.
Yeah.
I still like Breaking a Sweat the best. I think that's still my favorite worst.
Yeah.
Best worst song of Nick Hawk.
He's got a music video.
Can we play?
I like how your eyes just looked at the screen.
Please?
Okay.
Please?
So there's a commercial.
Oh, thank Jesus for a video. I've been waiting for a video.
Yeah. I didn't know that he had a video.
Oh, shit.
Oh, my God. Oh, my God.
This is the best thing I've ever seen in my life.
Why don't you describe what's going on for people?
I don't know if I can. I don't think I can't describe it without being embarrassed. Can you?
Yeah. It's called We Fight. And it begins by him walking in a, it looked like a, in the desert, twirling a sword or some fighting instrument. In the manner that a martial arts expert would.
Right.
And now he's walking around a fire.
There's
shirtless.
Fire and he's shirtless. This is very Steven Seagal-y, by the way.
I'm predicting he ends up fighting himself. That's what we're going to see.
Okay, okay.
That there's
going to
be two people and that they're both him.
Oh, right.
That's what I'm thinking.
Yeah, it's always about him.
Right.
Yeah.
Yes. Fight.
Fighting with the sword.
Oh, my God.
And
why do you
fire?
Shoot it on an iPhone? You can tell right away that, like, the video quality.
So shitty.
God damn it, man.
I know. At least rent a decent fucking camera.
Spend your fucking money on it.
You got money? He's nice twirling.
You're always
hoeing.
Just use some of that hoe money.
Jesus. And then it's too dark. You can't even see
him. Yeah, you got to hire a grip.
You need lighting.
Yeah.
Come on, bro. What are you, fucking new?
The songs sound very similar, like one to the, with the exception of the country song. This
right.
also sounds like the last song.
Okay. Well, I'm too distracted. Oh. Now he's in a gi and he's you know,
different looks.
Posturing, and now he's in a jacket and he's saying we fight. Yeah, it's
he got new ink.
Did he get
He got
new
so
ink?
Much ink on that one arm and chest and shoulder that it's just all black now.
Hey, now, does Steven Seagal make music?
Yes.
Oh, the harmonica? Or is that Bruce
Willis?
No,
he plays the blues.
Right.
And he sings.
Right.
Steven does. Like, legit.
And is he
plays.
Good? Like, is he okay, is Steven Seagal better at singing than Nick Hawk is at singing?
Yes.
Okay.
Very much.
We fight. I slay all my battles like a dragon, carry too much weight.
Oh, God. Giving. Let's just see if he.
I'm so embarrassed.
Himself. I want to see if he fights himself.
Okay, yeah. Who's he going to fight?
Is he working out here? What's going on?
Of course. That's what he does. He works out. He twirls the sword. Oh, shit. Now he's on a rock and he's on a rock.
Okay. There you go. I won't. Torture you anymore.
And it's an iPhone shooting again. He's on a rock.
He's doing Tai Chi.
Spreading his wings. What is happening?
I'm so surprised. He has the behavior of somebody really into coke, but I don't think he does it. You know? He has a lot of coke head behavior.
I know what you're talking about. Like, Creation was kind of like this. Well, just twirling. He never fights anybody. He
and
just
I
twirls.
Was wrong. He didn't fight himself.
Oh, it's got 94,000 views
on it.
Yeah,
it's a lot of views, man.
Good, Nick, good.
Let's see. When was it released? It was released...
man.
February.
Wow, good for him.
This song is honestly so cringeworthy.
Read some other reviews, let me see.
You did it again, great job. Uh-huh. It's like Rich Voss's son decided to smoke weed and not give a care. Needs more sky punches.
I wonder who came up with that.
Yeah.
Yeah, he does need a crazy Lokes to help him.
Great job. I like the constant changing of the backgrounds. Oof.
Yeah.
Yeah. Extremely passionate on many levels.
Oh, that's good. That's positive. That's nice. That is accurate.
Love it. And you are smoking hot. There you go.
Okay.
Love it. Amazing. Can't wait to jam out to this. Feeling it. I love your voice. You're definitely more than just a pretty face.
Is this a guy? An older man?
That's a woman. Fierce. That's how I would best describe you.
Yeah.
Fierce. We fight. I'm digging it. Great job. You got a lot of love.
Good. Well, there you go. Maybe we're wrong.
Yeah.
Maybe this, this could be a huge hit.
Could be, man.
I don't know.
It hasn't been up that long. You got about 100,000 views. Yeah, a lot of there people are digging it. So very well, happy
maybe,
for you.
Maybe I'm not the music aficionado I thought I was.
Yeah, you always. I mean, to be fair, I've never, you know, said that I understand music that well, but Christina definitely does. So definitely yeah. Get on her.
Sure. Get on me.
Yeah, yeah. If like I'm saying if you're mad.
No. No, at Tom Segura.
No.
Let him know how you feel.
But hey, good attempt.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
We can't all be breaking a sweat.
He'll probably copyright claim this episode too.
Yeah, well, you know, it's a price you pay for greatness. Well, look, man, we're, you know, we're putting his name out there.
Yeah,
is there
we're
anything
actually
wrong with that?
Giving you more attention, which is a good thing. All publicity, yeah. You know?
In show business, any publicity is good publicity. So, yeah. You know.
Yeah.
This is a highly powerful show you're listening to. We've had Gloria Stefan on. Brendan Urie of Panic at the Disco listens to our show. A lot of celebrities. Joe Rogan.
Your mate, Brace.
Brace.
He's been on multiple times.
Multiple times. We're a huge Brace fan.
Yeah. Yeah.
So, there you go.
Ask Grace. Jeans.
Yeah.
There's always, you know what I'm saying, that you want to keep track of.
Yeah.
This man's actually been in before, but he has a new appearance.
Okay.
And I think he wanted to trump his last appearance. Because his new, you know what I'm saying, count is out of control. It's DJ Khaled, The Keys of Life. He was on Kimmel and... check this. Oh shit, I'm already fucking up. You can see
I can see his lips saying, you know what I'm saying. Look at Kimmel has to be like, uh-huh.
Yeah. It's crazy.
You know what I'm saying? And you know what I'm saying?
And this is, by the way, obviously one sit down.
Yeah.
Sometimes these things are over, like, you know, a guy's getting interviewed
in a
studio. It might be an hour long. This is in a six-minute
spot. 6 minutes, yeah.
Saying, well, actually, I want to Snapchat the whole birth.
You
know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? Like,
I know what you're saying.
You know what I'm saying?
I got the keys.
You know what I'm saying?
What's this gentleman's name?
DJ Khaled.
I would say, per time, this might be the champion.
Yeah,
in terms of...
Like, he did the Breakfast Club.
Uh-huh.
That morning radio show in New York.
Uh-huh.
And his, you know what I'm saying, were just outrageous.
Yeah.
But it was also like an hour.
Okay, so that's what I'm saying. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Is for the time, ratio to, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
High level, high volume here.
High volume.
This is a contender for the most, you know what I'm saying, in the shortest amount of time, I would say.
Yeah.
Yes, quantity.
Mm-hmm.
In time. Wow, that's a really good one. I'm very impressed.
It's very impressive. So,
now the funniest one, there's the funniest, you know what I'm saying? The most, you know what I'm saying, is in the shortest amount of time.
Yeah. It's an ongoing, you know, you'll never actually really win, you know what I'm saying? But the whole idea is that you,
I keep licking the mic. My mouth keeps touching it.
Oh.
What's your favorite, you know what I'm saying?
My favorite, you know what I'm saying? I don't know. There's a few. I mean, it's hard to just label one.
Try to say,
hey, I'm talking about, you feel me?
Yeah,
I mean,
it's a good
that's
one.
That's pretty great. Yeah.
One of my favorites is the Japanese one. You know what I'm saying?
Oh, right, right.
Y'all.
You like hip hop, yo?
Yeah.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
You know what I'm saying?
Y'all.
You know what I'm saying?
You know what I'm saying?
You
know what I'm saying?
Yo.
You know what I'm saying?
That's a great one.
아니야? 이거 하지 마.
That's her just repeating a sound.
이거 질림?
Just know what
you're saying.
I got a 2001 Chevrolet Suburban, you know what I'm saying? For the city. It took me about 6 months to put it together. I had it like just like 2 years now, you know what I'm saying? You know,
this Rob guy, he's always great.
Shouts out to homeboy Mitch, you know what I'm saying?
Slickster.
Hell yeah, you know what I'm saying? Mutual homie. Good motherfucker right there, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So, you know what I'm saying? He's only going to fuck with the real, you know what I'm saying? So,
yeah.
Real recognized real game, recognized game, you know what I'm saying?
It's a good one.
Ain't no boss.
He goes off on that.
Yeah, but play my favorite one.
Oh.
You know the best one.
I know, but I don't think I have it queued up, though.
Oh, okay.
You know? Yeah, the best one is...
Well,
man, I never had that.
Yeah, best in terms of funniest. Yeah. I don't mean in quantity.
Yeah, yeah.
This guy might be the champ for as many, you know what I'm saying, in a shortest time, especially on television, too, on Kimmel.
That's outrageous.
This is a huge platform for, you know what I'm saying.
It is outrageous.
This isn't just like some radio interview.
This, Safir, though, this is my favorite one, Safir.
Okay. Yeah, check it out. You know what I'm saying? It's Safir. You know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? Check this out, though. I'm throwing a motherfucking shout out to my man, Boss Man. You know?
Just because he triples up at the top.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? You know
that's pretty great.
Who was that one? You know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying?
Who's that?
You know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying?
There's a few of those, though. It's hard to.
He talks about holding in his, he's not bagogging before a game.
Oh.
He's like, you know what I'm saying?
Oh, right. That came in more recently.
But you know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying?
Oh, that was
like,
Kimbo.
That's Kimbo. Yeah, that was a good one, too.
Oh, you're right.
You know what I'm saying?
Rest in peace. Yeah.
Oh, he's dead?
He died a couple weeks ago.
What?
Yeah.
Oh, no. How?
He's 42.
How did he die?
Heart attack?
I think so.
Yeah.
Oh, damn it. I didn't know that.
Yeah. Well, way to go.
I'm super bummed. That guy was super funny. Wow.
Yeah.
42. Damn, that's what sucks about being 40 now is like, I could die.
Yeah.
I mean, most people don't, but now yeah, motherfuckers are dying over 40. You know what I mean?
It could happen. Then people are like, yep, you know, that's just the way it goes.
Yeah. And now if I die, it's like not a big deal.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Yeah.
People could be like,
no, I don't know what you're saying. I don't know what you mean.
All right.
All right. You know what I'm saying?
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So, a brand new case of foreign accent syndrome has come about.
My favorite disease.
It's one of the OG topics of our show, and you may remember the first time we ever played it.
I have not actually heard my voice in a conversation for nearly 3 years now.
3 years now.
That is a British woman who woke up one day with foreign accent syndrome, and now it is attacking a woman in Texas. You know what accent she woke up with, Jeans?
What?
British.
Oh, cool.
Yeah.
Let's hear it.
But people who've met me before, they're shocked first, and then most people say, oh, I love it. But for me, it's a lot different.
Wow.
Yeah.
All right, listening to this mother, you'd think she was from London, but she was actually born and raised right here in Texas.
Strange but true, and it's an extremely rare case called foreign accent syndrome, but doctors say it actually happens, and now
it actually
she's
happens.
Working to try to get her normal speech back.
There's like 15 cases worldwide reported.
Right.
It's so rare. It's like a double pipe class.
Yeah, I was going to say, for language.
Wow.
As people look
Lisa
at me.
Oh, I'm not from England, sorry.
Is 100% Texan.
People who don't know me, hey, where are you from? I'm from Rosenberg. Oh, where's that? I'm like, we're here in Rosenberg. Oh, you're from
where's
here.
That?
How'd you talk like that? So that's when the whole story comes up.
It's amazing.
I don't buy this. Do you buy this?
Well, no, there was the one that was fake. Remember the fake one that was clearly fake? We played it a long time ago.
Uh-huh.
This lady claimed that she had it, and then she walked. The camera came. And they saw her walking in the parking lot.
Yeah.
And then they stopped her, talked to her, and then when she walked sideways, like she was doing a little bit of an act. Because she said it was a whole neurological thing. And
yeah, you know, I tend to think that these people need attention.
Yeah.
It might just be she's like bored and wants some attention.
I mean, but it does happen though, right? I mean,
I don't know.
Oh, you're saying you don't believe it at all?
I don't know. The one lady who, and for you now, that one,
yeah,
she legitimately was a bit tortured by it.
She seemed tortured.
Because she was like, I want to talk the way I used to talk.
Yeah.
She was like that.
Uh-huh.
She's like, she really was
How
upset.
She was like,
yeah, I want to talk the way I used to talk. Remember? She talked like that for 3 years now.
Yeah. Yep.
That's how she said it.
Mm-hmm. That is how she said it.
She did. You do it. You're the master of accents. Do her doing the accent.
Yeah. I have not actually heard my voice in a conversation.
In conversation.
For nearly 3 years now.
For you now.
3 years now.
See, because she...
Mom is probably the one word I noticed right away. Kitten. They think I'm talking about a baby cat, and I'm not. I'm saying I'm just kidding, but it's kitten. I'm just kidding.
But how would she have mastered the accent? I mean, she's not me.
She watched TV, man. That's true. She's listening to your show.
But she's like some, you know, fucking lady from Texas.
I don't know, man.
I don't think.
Man. Because they played, remember when they played
the, I didn't know the reaction I was going to
the British lady's answering machine?
I didn't know. Yeah. Are they going to judge
And me? They played her before she had the foreign accent syndrome, and she was really sad when she heard herself.
Yes, yes.
She was like, oh, I wish I could talk this away again.
Yeah.
That's what she did.
I remember. She was like, I wish I could. Yeah. I talk like a this again.
Yes. Yeah. I want to talk like a this now.
Yep.
This one, I don't believe anybody that has clear braces, do you?
Not one.
A succulent Chinese meal.
That's what the other lady was talking
like. Yeah, I don't like it when people do the clear brace. When I do the Invisalign, you know, people can still see them, but then you don't have, you know, nerdy-ass clear braces.
Or yeah, you dumb Brit.
Go old school, man. Get the metal.
Do you think...
Don't you think the clear braces are just worse than the old school metal ones?
I don't know.
Because you're not fooling anybody. We still know you have the braces.
We're only fooling people from a distance. But actually, their mouths still kind of
That's
push
what I'm
out.
Saying. You, I know. You can still tell.
I have to pee so badly again. It's a pee.
Well, so Yana. Could that be because of your showboating around with the water drinking? Because you're not accustomed to drinking this much.
Are they going to think I'm lying? Are they going to even understand how I'm speaking?
It doesn't sound... Here's the thing, though. A lot of these people, I think the fakies, sometimes you hear it dip, you know? Like, it doesn't sound like it's there all... Like, the Chinese accent lady had it 100%.
All the time, yeah.
But her, she's like, are they going to think I'm lying? It doesn't sound 100%.
And she's speaking, like, Cockney. She's not...
Yeah.
Think I'm lying. Like, she kind of does, like, a lower class.
I'm stopping this. I have to
pee. Wow. Interesting winner of the poll. Let everybody see that he can't hold his water.
Well, look how much I've drank.
Because it's not a custom for you, is it?
No one's accustomed. If you drank this much water, you have to pee.
What did you say? No one's accustomed. Meaning you.
No.
Because why? This is out of the norm for you.
No, it doesn't matter. You drink this much every day.
Wait a minute. You don't drink this much every day.
Yes, I do. And your body still has to get rid of it.
But if you drink this much every day, we never have to break twice for you to pee.
I'm drinking more this episode at this moment.
Uh-huh.
But that doesn't mean...
Well, why? Why are you drinking more of this episode? Why?
So I'm letting them know what I normally do after the show. Uh-huh. I'm doing it during the show.
Okay, sure.
So that's the only difference.
Okay.
Yeah.
Go ahead and urinate again, old man.
So
who's
Christina,
abusive now?
Christina
that
seems
was
to
super
think-
abusive. God, you sounded like Ike Turner just then.
No, here's the part that I feel like.
Let me tell you, daddy.
Well, I feel like you just don't get it. You're
no, you don't get it.
No, you don't. Let me explain. You're like, oh, you're not used to it. That's
you're not,
why you're.
That you're has, not used to that, drinking no, this much water
that's
at
not true.
Once.
That's not true.
How is
let
that
me finish
not
and
true?
I'll explain it to you because you don't get it. You don't get a lot. But.
Unbelievable.
Any body that consumes this much water, whether it be the first time they ever did it or they do it every day, your body has to get rid of the fluid.
Duh.
Yeah, so you're saying, like, anybody who just downs half a gallon in an hour is not like, I'm used to it, so it doesn't have to come out.
Not true.
That's not, no.
Not true.
You don't get it.
You don't get it because you don't hydrate as much as I do. I can drink an entire
you could not drink this much
long skinny from Trader Joe's.
So could I. That's not a lot of water.
In the car and sit in traffic for an hour, and my bladder accommodates because I'm so used to drinking so much.
No.
Expands and accommodates the pee, the urine.
No. No, you don't get it.
No, you don't get it.
First of all, you don't drink a lot of water.
First of all, this is all theatrics. I'm going to prove that you're just doing this for the cameras. When the cameras are off, it's dehydration city. Your pee is brown. You're such an animal. That doesn't prove anything. And these people are just totally being sold a lie. If you guys believe this fucking pony show, dog and pony nonsense. Oh, my God. All right, Tom, enough. You're going to have to pee again. Okay, you're going to make yourself sick. Seriously, you're not supposed to drink a gallon of water in an hour. It's really not good for you.
It is good for you. I do it every day.
Oh, my God. This is how kids on ecstasy die, is overwatering.
Oh, feels normal to me. My vision's a little blurry, but I feel fine.
Okay, could you stop now?
Yeah.
Okay.
Look, we got to wrap this up soon. What do you got?
Yeah, you
got
to go to the hospital.
Babe.
Bear! That was my favorite. She's like reasoning with him. Bear, don't forget, you're not supposed to be awake, Bear.
The double pipe classic shirt now on sale.
That is the coolest shirt. I got to get one of those shirts. That is beautiful. I love that.
That is not cool at all. It's the opposite of cool.
He was talking about the double pipe classic, babe.
Not I love hentai.
You don't remember this is mostly an audio show?
I know that, but there are people watching. And
right,
it doesn't
I
make
know.
Sense to people watching.
Okay, good.
Oh, good.
Got a fucking amateur over here.
That is the coolest shirt. I got to get one of those.
Okay, well, we're talking about Double Pipe Classic shirt, okay?
Jesus. You know... You wouldn't be so grouchy and abusive right now if you didn't force yourself to drink water more than you normally do.
I didn't. I
usually
normal.
This time of day, you're drinking your brown cup of coffee and you're dehydrated.
Guys, for everyone watching or not watching, 3/4 of a gallon down.
That's not
an hour
good. And anybody with a brain in their head knows that that's bad.
It's not bad.
To do in one sitting.
It's not
that
bad.
That is the dumbest
it's
thing you've ever done.
Standard for okay. buns.
It is not standard.
The water champ.
It's
I'm
not
H2
standard.
Flo. She's okay. H2
Is there
no.
a medical professional we can consult?
Yeah.
That's so dumb.
I'm going to the doctor.
Remember
Thursday,
when we, first of all, we had our blood drawn at the doctor's office last week, and they couldn't find a vein on you because you're so dehydrated. And when they did, they pulled your blood out. It was like syrup.
No.
She goes, because you're so absolutely.
No, you're such a liar.
It took-
you're such a filthy liar.
Oh my God. How long did it take them
you're
to find
such-
a vein?
Such. That long- has to do with being fat, you jerk.
No, but she pulled your blood out and it was like chocolate syrup.
No, she couldn't find a
no,
vein.
And then she finally did and she goes, you need to drink more water.
No,
she And she
didn't.
Handed you water.
No, she didn't. No, she didn't. I live with
my.
A sociopathic liar.
Okay.
I live with a fucking psycho.
I'm telling
psycho.
You, she said your blood's really thick. You need to drink water.
No, she
you
never
don't remember.
Said those words, ever. She didn't
you
say
really
your
think
blood's so thick.
She did.
You need to drink. No,
well,
she did
how
not.
How could I make that up?
No, she didn't.
How did I know? How would I know that? I'm not a medical professional.
Hey, Looney Tune. She offered me
how?
Apple juice.
Because you're dehydrated
no,
severely.
She said it's your energy.
She didn't give me any apple juice or water okay. because I was fine. She goes, your blood is too thick. You need to drink water now.
Look, you're so upset that you lost the H2O champ fucking contest. The vote came in. You're Bernie. I'm Hillary. I got the nomination. And you're like, I'm still going to stay at 1% of the 2%. You lost. Deal with it. No more delegates. You lost because you hang out with these fucking bums.
These losers. You know what? I don't care anymore. If they want to believe a lie, let them.
All right.
You guys like being hosed by Hillary over here?
All right. Look, we got to get going. I love you.
I don't love you anymore.
I know, but I love you. And
I stopped loving you today.
Thank you guys for listening. It's not a nice thing to say.
Why?
Because it's not nice.
I just started loving you again.
Okay.
I stopped for those 30 seconds and then I love you again.
I drank so much water.
Stop and, it. oh my God. Oh my God.
Oh my God. Oh my God. Thank you guys for listening. Thank you guys for sending in all the funny stuff, whether it be clips, songs, the translations. Very fun episode.
Except for one part I didn't really enjoy at all.
My kidneys hurt. Please go to yourmomshousepodcast.com.
Where can they buy the shirts?
They can go to yourmomshousepodcast.com, click on the store, or tomsegura.com, click on the store there, which is the shop button.
Yeah.
And yeah, if you just go to my site, actually.
Oh my God, oh my God.
That'll be the shop for it. This outgoing song is by Clado. And that's it.
Oh,
that's
here we go. It's another fucking.
No, it's not about you.
Thank you.
All right. Bye, guys.
Pards.
Your mom's house.
Pards.
Your mom's house.
Happy hoes eat, sad hoes don't. Happy hoes eat, sad hoes don't.
Why is Bert Kreischer so fat? So fat. So fat. So fat. Why is Bert Kreischer so fat? So fat. So fat. So fat.
That's a good question. Bert's an alcoholic. He's diabetic. He's a sad hoe, like we were just talking about. He's so sad he eats extra. And that's why Bert's so fat.
So fat.
So fast. You know, I've been in and out of jail, you know what I'm saying? I did a little bit of everything. I ain't never had a job in my life. My sensei, Seagal, was telling me the Buddha nature is just to be in the moment. You know what I'm saying? 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 You know what I'm saying?
Why is Bert Kreischer so fast? So fast. So fast. So fast. Why is Bert Kreischer so fast? So fast. So fast. So fast.
That's a good question. Bert's an alcoholic. He's diabetic. He's a sad hoe, like we were just talking about. He's so sad he eats extra. And that's why Bert's so fat.
So fat, so fat. So fat. So fat, so fat. So fat. Hashtag DJ Dadmouth. Hashtag DJ Dadmouth.